One love.
Action continuing apace here, and two more stars of the sport going head-to-head here on the Infinity Arena, round of 32. Action continuing here at this inaugural WTT Champions event. Brand new marquee stop in the WTT series.
One, two.
It's funny, you get a lot of questions already, Fraser, about, okay, so... Where's the YouTube streaming from the other tables as well? Just had to answer, well, there isn't any this week. It's all here.
Yep, all in the Infinity Arena.
We have a feeder tournament, of course, going on, but in terms of this event, no other tables being used. This is very much the focus here, the Infinity Arena for this.
And I must say it looks fantastic. With the purple theme, player tunnels, taking the sport to a new level, visually.
3-2.
See a lot of the Japanese women with strong serves.
Left 3-2.
Nice there from Gihara. Good shot selection. She picked out the right one to fade down the line. Just talking about the serves there. Gihara very strong. The hook serves. And they have quite versatile receives as well with the strawberry flicks and whatnot.
2-5.
She's missed out there, but that's actually a nicely put together point, wasn't there? With some changes of pace, Fraser, and depth there from Kihara.
Absolutely, it was a nicely constructed point, played into the middle and down the line. That was the right idea. Strong execution.
5-4.
Last one there, she just snatched that. Took a little bit too early. The ball had barely bounced. You want to take it early, but not that early. But I think she's the intention's good from Kihara. She doesn't want to get into these exhausting rallies of just looping into the long pimples because it gets heavier and harder to lift.
5-0.
Well, we often say this, don't we, about younger players. The thing is, Yukihara's actually played a lot of choppers comparatively at this point in her career. Actually, doesn't have an amazing record against them.
6-5.
You were saying about the fact that, you know, you have a younger player here, Kihara. Often it takes younger players time, doesn't it, against choppers to really work it out, to develop that patience.
Absolutely. Comes with experience. Kind of like playing a left-hander as a right-hander in the sense that there's fewer defenders than there are attackers. And of course, a lot fewer left-handers than right-handers. Less than 10% of the women's top 100. Just insane how much of a wall Han Ying is. Honestly, how many shots you've got to string together.
And then that's the point about the younger players. We've seen it a couple of times. I think Kihara's actually started well here, but it's that constant question, isn't it? Can you mentally stay there?
Oh, that's
a fantastic receive from the Japanese. I read that. But it's whether you can stay there mentally, just keep going, ball after ball. It's often what younger players have that difficulty to maintain that.
Ben, 7.
You've got to watch Han Ying as well because she twiddles. can come in with the attack if there's anything too loose.
Three game points.
11-7.
And she takes the first here. The work not done for Ma Long there. Just got a quick look at him. Signing some autographs. Of course, he won his match previously against Robert Gardosh.
Love one.
I'll have to correct myself from before. Actually, Han Ying doesn't need to twiddle coming in with the short pimples with the punch.
2-1.
The only time she twiddles actually is when she serves. She'll serve with the smooth rubber so she can get a bit more spin and then twiddle to have the pimples on the backhand side.
1-3.
1-4. What a receive that was there.
She's reading the service very well. We saw that a couple of times, Fraser, in the opening game. Kihara able to unload on the receive rather than just push. Really strike through the ball.
Yeah, nice crisp attacks. She's contacting the ball really nicely.
4-3.
A stunning counter from Han Ying.
4-3.
Just as you said in the opening game, that comes back and comes back again and again. Backhand chop, so much quality.
Yeah, and she can vary it. The full chop has a little bit more spin than the kind of smaller chop.
4-0.
You've got to be constantly watching her. And a lot of the modern defenders have fantastic attacks. See Ruben Phyllis, another German player in the men's game, can come in and swoop over the ball.
5-4.
That's a great comparison point you make, I think, Fraser, there as well with Phyllis, you know, in the terms of the modern defender, you know, in terms of a development, because you know, the old-fashioned defender is just very, very difficult to prosper with that style in the modern game.
6.
Yes, there's not as many out-and-out defenders now as there used to be.
He's been kind of a hybrid defender, which is, you know,
exactly.
They've got a couple of Germans there, as you say, Han Ying and Ruin Phyllis as well, on the men's side. Got to bring a bit more, haven't you, in addition to the top quality chop.
4-7.
She's up to consistency here with the forehand, Han Ying. Guiding that one back. Wasn't really a counter, but it wasn't really a block either.
7-5.
Wasn't in the best position to play the forehand.
Of 2 for the German. Up back
8-5.
Edge. Chopping on the forehand side this time. That unplayable, of course, off the edge from Han Ying.
Beaten so many of the top players in the world. One of Han Ying's best ever wins was against Chen Xintong, which he's beaten players like Samara, Chen Yiqing, and Miu Hirano as well.
6-8.
Very decorated player as well. European wise, with 6 European Table Tennis Championship medals.
7-8.
Kihara coming back here. Good placement. I wonder how many autographs Ma Long signed in his career.
Probably less than the number of forehand winners he's played. But.
Very good, Fraser.
9-7.
punch there from Kihara. Strictly so. 2 points from taking this second.
8-10.
What serve just bit into the table. Mm. Venom there. Similar service action coming around the side. The hook serve. Good disguise from Han Ying.
11-8.
Second game then for Han Ying.
Very, very tired playing a defender.
Kihara to serve.
And the longer this match goes on, the more tired, especially, Kihara is going to become.
1-1.
And a gift for Han Ying there. At the start of this third game.
2-1.
Yeah, that error there, it's back on your point, Fraser. Again, it's just another ball, isn't it? And it's even when she makes that, when she's had to play three or four more the next time around, it's just the investment of Han Ying. She's done this against so many players.
3-1. That was a nice play there from Kihara, yeah. Moving Han Ying in and out of the table. And when she'd come in, Kihara then put it into the body. That was good. But yeah, I mean, that second ball, second point, she missed the point. It looks a bit cavalier, a bit casual. It's not over until it's over.
2-0.
It's interesting, I made the point earlier about Kihara's win rate against defenders because it's below 50%, but a lot of that is to do with, if you look at her career, very good, very young, playing top-level events. She's getting stronger now all the time, physically. Mm. She gets older. So expect those numbers to improve, but it's still so demanding.
Yeah, absolutely.
3-0.
It's tough as a very, very young kid to beat an experienced defender. But I'm sure that that rate of 50% will increase as Kihara becomes, you know, close to 20 years of age.
3-4.
And that physicality as well is the key factor. Strengthen the legs and waist to come up the back of it. It is a very physical game against a defender of this magnitude.
3-4.
Teases another error out of Kihara.
6.
The length there, as well as the bite on the chop. Too much for Kihara. What would the Japanese national team, Fraser, for you, what would they have done as Pangbin? What would they have done in terms of preparing here? Obviously, she's played her reasonably recently. Nicely there. What would she have done to prepare for this, or what they have done with her to prepare her for this?
Well, I think there would have been a good amount of multi-ball training, actually. You know, the coach stepping a little bit further back from the table and chopping into the forehand of Kihara just to get her accustomed to the amount of spin she'll be facing against Han Ying.
6.
And you'll be pushing a few more balls against the defender than you will be against an attacker, so some push practice as well, I imagine. Maybe push to push.
Interesting.
7-6.
Constant, examination physically and mentally of Kihara. She's standing up well to it here, the Japanese.
Six, eight.
Started poorly in this third game as well, so she's done well to regain composure. Mature performance, good composure.
Six,
nice movement there,
nine.
She's staying low, regaining, bringing the right foot back so then she can transfer weight forward through the left leg. Nice technique on the forehand from Kihara. She's got
then
nice hands on
six.
The pushes as well. I like how smooth she is coming in with that shot. Very relaxed.
There's
the third game. Really good run.
Fourth game, Han to serve level.
Han Ying here. 2-1 down to Miu Kihara. Youth at the moment is trumping experience. Will it stay that way?
Let love all. One,
clips the net
love.
Once, clips the net again, but the second one sends it long. And Ying being able to do well there to change, which he would have done after the trajectory changes off the net.
Love, two.
Back on the previous point, though, I think she's heard there, Fraser, but there was just a little nod. Okay, I'm okay with that. I've got my game plan. What we've seen so far, there is that clarity of thought.
Well, that's it exactly,
one,
you know.
Two.
If you stick to the game plan but lose, you can't really complain too much. You can admit then that you were outclassed. If you don't have a plan, then less likely to win. Depending on who you are.
2-0.
Slightly improving numbers, but she's losing out to Kihara. Points one behind the service at the moment, Han Ying. Drops another one there.
Says to herself, I probably should have played the forehand counter. Amazing rally, but Kihara going a little bit flat with that. And flatter shots are higher risk because, of course, the table isn't huge. You want to have a bit of arc on the ball, increases the likelihood of it to come on the table.
Four,
you've got to play with that patience still, respect the ball and its merits, which is what Kihara did there.
She's been against a bit of luck in this game. Two or three nets.
Like it a lot. Instruction again, really good from Kihara. Going hard into the Han Ying forehand there. Putting up the table.
Six,
beautiful play.
Four.
Brilliant play from Kihara.
Love the change there. Here we see it. Middle, gets a weaker ball, closes out the angle off the bounce. That is top, top, top draw.
And with more shape as well, as you say. She didn't really slap that.
Mm. She needs the shape.
Oh, and that's an example of it. That's the best. We've seen Kiss is the sideline of the table there.
And kisses Han Ying goodbye in that point. That was just unreachable, even for a defender. To play the angles is paramount, and that was class. Placing it into the body as well. Good way to play a defender, that. Play the first one into the body, get a weaker ball, and then you can maybe attack a bit easier.
Oh. 4-9. She's going through a purple patch here on the Infinity Arena, Miu Kihara. 2 points away.
It seems to be slightly undisciplined nature to the slaps, though. I don't know what it is about that shot, but I think it is just the lack of shape of the shot. Han Ying won't be complaining.
Yeah, she's shown she can play with shape. We've seen, I mean, look at the previous points.
Yeah.
9-6.
A couple of mistakes now. And yeah, she's actually calling the timeout here rather than Pang Bin. Maybe there was a little look across, but I think that timeout's coming from the player as much as anything. Just wants to breathe here.
9-6.
Really, really testing the mental tenacity of players. Being able to just come here and perform from the get-go.
Yeah. Kihara here, off the timeout, resuming two away.
7-9.
Well, you wouldn't believe, would you, that Han Ying actually started out as an attacking player.
It's a great story, isn't it?
It really is. When you see the forehand, sometimes you can actually maybe see that.
Turns that one around, Kihara. Make the first match point, but two more to come and back with the service. And it was that purple patch here on the Infinity Arena that she put together, which might be enough. Set up these opportunities. Second match point. And there it is. Miu Kihara beats Han Ying again.